Good late afternoon, everybody. Now, as a request from Eli Grande, I'm now on, of course, I'm now going to do episode 4 of Jack Talks, in which, as a request from Eli Grande, he's requested me to review one of his favorite Disney films. This is a Disney film, and he requested me to do that, and this is one of his favorite Disney films. It's also one of my favorite Disney films. It's in my top 10. It's at number 7. It's Disney's 2013 box office blockbuster hit, Frozen, and I'll be reviewing that film. I only have one version, so I'll quickly show you. This is the 2014 Collector's Edition Blu-ray. Hey, it says, the best animated movie of the year, state by Scott Mance of Access Hollywood. I got this off of the Disney Movie Club back at the end of March. Anyway, I know a lot of people have this Blu-ray, including Marvelous Fine 99, Breezy Opposition 87. I think a couple others do. I know some actually have the standard edition DVD, which the cover art's a little bit different. And they also have one other character on the cover, that being Hans, the villain, Hans. Also have Hans on the cover of the DVD cover. Hans, we know, is the villain in this movie. And to be honest, I've seen that the DVD cover, and to be honest, I don't really like that cover. The cover for this Blu-ray, I actually really like. Like, because it's almost like the original theatrical poster. It looks nothing like the original theatrical poster, but has Elsa at the top and these two characters. And of course, yeah, and the original theatrical poster, it's also, you could, because as you could see on the Blu-ray cover, you could see Elsa on the top, and on the bottom you see Kristoff, Sven, Aunt Anna, and Olaf. Note, they're in their same area on the original theatrical poster, or Elsa at the top and the characters down there are the same. But anyway, here's Spine. In the back it says, an instant classic, this movie will be watched and loved for generations, was saved by Mark S. Allen of CBS/CW. And Disney Animation's Best Since The Lion King Will Melt Your Heart is saved by William Bibany of Crave Online. Features, we got Making of Frozen, Disney Frosted, Disney's Jury from Hans Christian Andersen to Frozen, deleted scenes, Let It Go, end credit music videos, Demi Lovato, and Martina Stolos, she performs it in Spanish and Italian, and the Get a Horse Mickey Mouse show, which I was really pissed off when I found out that that short didn't win Best Oscar. I really did want it to win, but oh well. What am I gonna do? See, yep, we got the Disney Movie Awards code. I already entered it in. Yep, this is the Disney Movie Awards. Frozen soundtrack, which I might go on Disney Movie Awards and get the soundtrack, I don't know. Fight the Freeze sweepstakes. And digital HD, which you would have to go online to get the digital copy. And here are the two discs. This one's the Blu-ray, this one's the DVD. Well, actually, you could tell that because it says right there, Blu-ray and DVD. So, if you haven't seen Frozen, definitely check it out. I did see this movie in theaters over at the Showcase Cinemas next to the Warwick Mall. Okay, now I'm not going to review what the film is. It opens with these men opening eyes as they sing a holy hole. And you could see a young boy, a young deer, that being Kristoff and Sven when they were young. They go out into the open, and then we cut to Arendelle, in which we go into the castle there. We see a little girl that's actually young Elsa, and her little sister, who's young Anna, who we know Anna is the main character in this movie, wakes her up and tells her that she needs to play and tells her to build a snow, ask her if she wants to build a snowman. They go into this little room, in the middle of the night. They play with the snow, they make a snowman. And Elsa is making these almost like snow steps, so Anna would keep jumping and Elsa would make the snow steps. But then Elsa couldn't keep up with Anna, and then when Anna jumped, she accidentally when she used the ice, it accidentally hit on his head. The king and queen, their parents, go see what happened, and one part of Anna's hair is turned white. So the king and queen, the parents, take them to this little area with trolls as Kristoff and Sven follow them, and a troll family who's actually really rock, comes and tells them to be quiet, but then Sven licks her, and then she goes, "Oh, you're cute. I'm gonna keep ya." And of course, the main chief of the troll family comes and helps recover Anna's head, but he takes out the memories of Elsa's magic, but he still leaves the memories of them having good times. And later on, Elsa and Anna become I'm a little bit apart, and every time snow comes, Anna keeps asking Elsa to play as she sings the popular song, "Do You Want to Build a Snowman?" Then one day, as they keep getting older, she keeps saying the line, "Do you want to build a snowman?" Of course, then Anna, as she's a teenager now, she looks just like this, goes into her parents' room saying, "Goodbye, see you in 2 weeks," because they were going away for 2 weeks. And Elsa actually asks them if they really have to go, and the king says they'll be fine. So then you see them aboard ship, then we cut to an area where a storm comes out in the ocean, the boat is going up and down, then we see a shot where the boat flips over and it sinks. The king and queen have died. There's a picture of them in the castle, and they cover it with a curtain. You can see two gravestones of them. And then we cut to Anna going over to Elsa's room in the dark. She's all upset. She sings, "Do you want to build a snowman?" in a quiet little voice. Then we cut to the middle of summer as there's text on the screen saying 3 years later. Anna is excited because it's coronation day, that everyone gets to come in and stuff as she sings the song for the first time in forever. Then a horse accidentally bumps her in, and she lands in a little mini boat. The mini boat's about to fall off a dock, but luckily the horse catches her, and she meets Prince Hans of the Southerns, who later on is the villain in this movie. The Southern Islands, and they talk to each other, and then coronation comes, and Elsa comes, and also Elsa has these gloves that'll control her powers in public, and then the party comes, and there's dancing and everything, Irish dancing, and Elsa and Anna finally get to talk to each other, and then they smell that they have this great smell, and they found out it's chocolate. Of course, then a guard comes, and then he says the popular line that's funny with the Duke. He says, "Behold, the Duke of Weaseltown," and the guy says, "Weaselton!" And, man, that's one of my favorite lines in the film. So, then, of course, then, Elsa tells Anna that, you know, this always can't be like this. And then Anna starts walking away, and then she meets Hans again, and they start hanging out with each other, and they start talking, and then they sing the song, "Love is an Open Door." And then, Hans actually proposes to Anna. Anna accepts the proposal, and they go to Elsa to ask for the blessing, but Elsa refuses. Anna grabs one of her gloves, and she keeps distracting Elsa. Elsa is getting so irritated that she yells, "Enough! Uff!" Of course, she did get too scared, and she made ice, and then she ran away over to an ocean. Anna starts following her, and Elsa leaves, and Anna decides to go after her, and then she leaves Hans in charge, and then we see Elsa going up to the North Mountain, and she sings the Academy Award Oscar-nominated one song, "Let It Go." Then the next morning, Anna is on the horse looking for Elsa. Of course, she falls off her horse, and the horse runs away. She goes to this little store and sauna, and she gets a winter outfit. That's the outfit she's wearing right there. And then Kristoff finally comes, and he's the way he looks right there. Also, Sven is also outside, and he's kind of arguing with the store clerk, which he goes, hoo-hoo. Of course, then Kristoff says to Elsa, I'm just going to deal with this crook here. And then we realize he's really tall, and then he throws Kristoff out, and then they go in this, Kristoff and Sven go into a little place to sleep, and now Anna comes in and tells them to take her up the North Mountain. They go up to the North Mountain, like, Kristoff is saying to Anna about when she's telling how, what happened in Arendelle, Kristoff kept saying, wait, you got proposed to you got engaged to someone you just met? He explains to the trolls, or his family, or he calls them friends, says, like, he's a love expert. Then these big wolves come and chase them, and they come to a cliff. Sven jumps over the cliff. He lets go with the sleigh, and him and Anna make it. Of course, Kristoff does make it across, of course, at the side of the mountain. He's about to fall off, but luckily, there was a little rope he grabbed onto, and he went back up. Decided relief, and then they continued on. They went into this ice forest, this area, and they meet my favorite character, Olaf. Snowman, and he knows it's the middle of summer, and he's explaining how it would be awesome to be in summer. Of course, he doesn't know that in the summer he's gonna melt as he sings the song In Summer. And then they continue on to the North Mountain, and of course, meanwhile, back in Arendelle, everything is freezing, and the horse comes back and tries to tell Hans that Anna is out there. So Prince Hans and a couple other of the men get on some horses, and they're now on their way up to the North Mountain. And Kristoff, Sven, Anna, and Olaf finally make it to up the North Mountain, and they go to Elsa's ice castle. Forgot to mention, which is, you know, there. They go in there. Anna tries to tell Elsa about that she needs to come back, and as she's, like, singing sort of like a refrain for the first time in forever. Of course, then Elsa is using one of her powers, and again, she accidentally strikes Elsa. Elsa used one of her powers, and she accidentally strikes Anna, but this time he strikes her heart. Then they leave. Of course, Elsa makes a snow monster to come and chase them away. They jump off the little cliff, and they land on the pillow. Kristoff actually says, Kristoff says as, I think I just broke my skull in that. Olaf says a funny line. I think this is actually my favorite line. I don't have a skull or bones. It was really funny. Anyway, and then they go, and we find out Anna's hair is turning more white. So they go, Kristoff takes her to meet the trolls. He takes them to the trolls. And they think that Anna is his girlfriend as they sing this song, Fixer Upper. Then Anna starts getting worse. She's ice cold and stuff. And the chief tells him that if it was her head, it would have been easier. But he can't do the heart. But only an act of true love can fix it. So they decide to take her back to Arendelle to meet Hans. While Hans and all the other men go up to the North Mountain and they go up to Elsa's ice castle. Elsa's up there hiding, and these two men who have these little crossbow areas come, and of course the snow monster comes, but luckily they push him off the cliff and make him fall and die. They go up, the two men with the bows come up to a little area, and the ice area that Elsa's staying in is somehow turning yellow. Well, and Elsa's standing there, and they have their little bows, and they're aiming them at Elsa, because they try to kill Elsa. Of course, then Elsa uses his ice, and then Hans comes up and sees this, and a guy who's still stuck behind the ice, but he has his crossbow free, and he's just about to kill Elsa as he shoots the arrow coming. Luckily, Hans pushes him, and the arrow hits the chandelier, starts falling down. Elsa runs away, but something happened and it knocked her out. She wakes up in a prison cell back in Arendelle, handcuffed. She tells Prince Hans that she doesn't know how to make Summer come back. Of course, then they arrive, Kristoff, Olaf, and Sven, and Anna finally return to Arendelle. They bring Anna to Prince Hans, but Prince Hans actually explains that this was all a setup, up and leaves Anna in there. Olaf finally does come in and makes a fire, and then he finally learns that he's gonna melt. He says anything is worth melting for. Of course, then he starts melting, but then he grabs onto his head that started melting and said, "But maybe not now. Ow. Ow." Of course, then Prince Hans goes over to a little area. He's talking with the men, and he actually sentenced to kill Elsa. So then Anna and Olaf realize Kristoff can almost be an act of true love. So then they take, Kristoff turns around with Sven as they go into the ice area by the ocean. Sven and Kristoff actually fall off the ice, and Kristoff just sees a bunch of water, and he thinks Sven is dead, but Sven comes back up, and he's like, oh, thank God. He runs over. Olaf and Kristoff Olaf and Anna are going over, and they're halfway to the scene, meaning, Kristoff. Of course, then, Elsa's out there, and Prince Hans tells him that Prince Hans tells her that Anna is dead, and Anna like sits down because of how upset she is, and it calms the winter down. Elsa sees this and tries to run over to Elsa. Prince Hans gets a sword out, and he's just about to aim at her. He's just about to kill Elsa, but then Anna stands in the way, and then she freezes. And of course, Froze actually like knocks off not makes Hans fall down and of course Elsa's there and she's crying and Olaf and Kristoff and Sven come there and they're like all upset. Of course Elsa's there, she's crying on the frozen Anna, and of course then Anna unfreezes, and it turns out Olaf says the act of true love between Anna and Elsa actually made Anna unfreeze. And then Elsa realized love can help her, and she makes Summer come back. And Olaf says, this is the best day ever. Of course, then he starts to melt because of Summer. He says, quite possibly my last. But Elsa thankfully uses her magic and gives him a flurry, like a little cloud with snow that follows him, make him last in Summer. Hans actually gets back up and tells Anna, I thought your heart, you had a frozen heart, and Anna says to him, the only person who has a frozen heart is yours, or yours. Of course, then she punches Hans, and then he falls off the ship and into the ocean, of course, then Anna then shows Kristoff in the middle of the day, his new sled. New sled, and then the kiss. Of course, then Olaf is there enjoying summer with his flurry above him, and then he accidentally sneezes because of the flowers, and Sven catches his carrot and he eats it. Throughout the film, Sven kind of sometimes tries to eat it, and they actually fight over it. Olaf and Sven actually fight over the carrot when Olaf's carrot lands on the ice. You could see it. That's in the teaser trailer that was shown in theaters. The teaser trailer attached to Monsters University, and you can also look it up on YouTube easily. Of course, then Sven gives Olaf his nose back, Elsa makes ice, and she allowing everyone to ice skate, and she's telling Anna they'll never close the gates again. Of course, then they just, that's about the end. Well, there you go, that's episode 4 of Jack Talks. Stay tuned for my next video.